Knowing well that as our hearts begin to worship, we'll be blessed because we came. We'll be blessed because we came.
This Mass is offered for the following intentions: thanksgiving to Jesus, Mary, and Joseph for protection from a serious accident, thanksgiving to Our Lady of Health, Velinkani, Our Lady of Perpetual Succor, and to the Lord Jesus for favors received, good health and blessings on Father Ruben Tellis, Father Elton Namori, birthday blessings for Karen Oliveira, silver wedding anniversary blessings for Sienna and Noel Criado, birthday remembrance for Gertrude De Penna, thanksgiving for good health and blessings received through the past year, for the souls of Carmen Marina Pereira being the first death anniversary, Savio Wallace, Gregory and Adeline Mendes, Benjamin and Mary Rodericks, Joseph Jacks De Silva, Mervyn and Shirley De Souza, Richard De Almeida, Mr. Giles, Philip Barreto and sisters, Mr. and Mrs. Robert Carvalho and the deceased members of the family, Esmeralda Carvalho, Esperanza Zavellino Rodericks, Manuel Povo, Mr. and Mrs. Margaret Povo, Guilhermina Baptista and Santana Baptista, Joe and Mabel Pereira, Julie DeMello, Kay Singh, John Peter Lobo, Millie Paul, Justin Faria, Cleta D'Souza, Alex D'Souza, Luisa and Joseph Ferreira. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Gathered around the Eucharistic table of the Lord, we praise and thank Him for His blessing showered on us and seek His pardon and forgiveness. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and what I have failed to do. Through my most grievous fault, therefore I ask the Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. The Almighty God, have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Lord, have mercy. Christ, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Let us pray. Grant, we pray, Almighty God, that we who have been renewed by paschal remedies, transcending the likeness of our earthly parentage, may be transformed in the image of our heavenly Maker. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen. A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. In those days, when Peter and John were released, they went to their friends and reported what the chief priests and the elders had said to them. And when they heard it, they lifted their voices together to God and said, Forbidden Lord, who made the heaven and the earth, and the sea and everything in them, who through the mouth of our father David, your servant, said by the Holy Spirit, why did the Gentiles rage, and the people plot in vain? The kings of the earth set themselves, and the rulers were gathered together against the Lord and against His anointed. For truly in this city they were gathered together against your holy servant Jesus, whom you anointed, both Herod and Pontius Pilate, along with the Gentiles and the people of Israel, to do whatever your hand and your plan had predestined to take place. And now, Lord, look upon their threats and grant to your servants to continue to speak your word with all boldness, while you stretch out your hand to heal
and signs and wonders are performed. Through the name of your holy servant Jesus. And when they had prayed, the place in which they were gathered together was shaken, and they were all filled with the Holy Spirit, and continued to speak the word of God with boldness. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Our response is, blessed are all who trust in you, O Lord. Kindly listen to the tune. Why do the nations conspire, and the peoples plot in vain? They arise, the kings of the earth, princes plot against the Lord and his anointed. Let us burst asunder their fetters. Let us cast off from us their chains altogether. He who sits in the heavens laughs. The Lord derides and mocks them. Then he will speak in his anger. His rage will strike them with terror. It is I who have appointed my king of Zion, my holy mountain. Altogether. If then you have been raised with Christ, seek the things that are above, where Christ is seated at the right hand of God.
Alleluia. Alleluia. The Lord be with you.
And your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. There was a man of the Pharisees called Nicodemus, a ruler of the Jews. This man came to Jesus by night and said to him, Rabbi, we know that you are a teacher come from God, for no one can do these signs that you do unless God is with him. Jesus answered him, truly, truly, I say to you, unless one is born anew, he cannot see the kingdom of God. Nicodemus said to him, how can a man be born when he is old? Can he enter a second time into his mother's womb and be born? Jesus answered, truly, truly, I say to you, unless one is born of water and the Spirit, he cannot enter the kingdom of God. That which is born of the flesh is flesh. That which is born of the Spirit is spirit. Do not marvel that I said to you, you must be born anew. The wind blows where it wishes, and you hear its sound, but you do not know where it comes from or where it goes. So it is with everyone who is born of the Spirit. The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. From Gospel texts, we always know that the Pharisees had a deep problem with Jesus, especially because his teachings had a lot of confrontation of them, and also he spoke about being the Son of God. But Nicodemus was someone who looked beyond these differences, and he would come to Jesus by night in order to be catechized. And today's text of the Gospel is once again a reminder to Nicodemus that in order to understand God's ways, one must be born anew. But Nicodemus looks at it from a human point of view. He fails to realize that being born anew means being born with Spirit. And that's where the words of today's response, blessed are you who trust in the Lord, blessed are those who trust in you, O Lord. And this is the trust we must always have in a God who loves us and cares for us, and because of whom we are able to think of heavenly things. This is the challenge for all of us, to look beyond our human weakness and to be able to live a life full of the Spirit. because it is the Spirit that directs us and guides us and also inspires to do great things in the name of the Lord. Let us pray for this intention during our Eucharist today. Let us pray that your sacrifice and mine may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands, to the praise and glory of his name, for our good and for all his holy church.
Receive, O Lord, we pray, these offerings of your exalted church, and as you have given her cause for such great gladness, grant also that the gifts we bring may bear fruit in perpetual happiness. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, at all times to acclaim you, O Lord, but in this time above all to laud you yet more gloriously, when Christ our Passover has been sacrificed. For with the old order destroyed, the universe cast down is renewed, and integrity of life is restored to us in Christ. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exults in your praise. And even the heavenly powers with the angelic hosts sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim.
Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts,
heaven and earth
are full of your glory. Hosanna in the Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
Savior of the world, for by your cross and resurrection, you have set us free.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Oswald, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, a spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Amen. At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope, the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant a peace and unity in accordance with your will, where you live forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always. Let us offer each other a sign of peace. Peace be with you. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. Our act of spiritual communion together. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, we thank you for this nourishment we have received from the celebration of the Passion, Death, and Resurrection of your Son, Jesus. May we always lose ourselves in you and discover your love for us. And may we reflect this love to everyone whom we encounter. Bless our efforts in bringing peace and joy in this world, especially during these times of insecurity. Forgive us, for the times we have failed to understand your will. Bless and strengthen us and protect us from all harm. We make this prayer through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
We go in peace to love and serve the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Spirit of God in the clear running water,
blowing through grapes,
the trees on the hill. Spirit of God in the vapor of falling,
fill me up. Pray to the
man, Lord, where you will.
Blow till I be, but breath of the Spirit.